Today I'm going to discuss with you the assignment which I gave you on the chapter linear equations in one variable. So quickly check the solutions of these questions. So the first question was solve the following linear equation. So the first part is x by 2 minus 1 by 5 is equal to x by 3 plus 1 by 4. So what we can do is we can transpose the terms containing variables to one side and constants to the other side. So here we see that x by 3 minus x by 2 is equal to minus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 5. Right, this step is correct. So now on the left side you can take 6 as LCM, as you can see over here, and then you get in the numerator 2x minus 3x, perfectly fine. So now on the right hand side you will see you can take 20 as LCM, so you get minus 5 minus 4 on the numerator. So this is right. So 2x minus 3x gives you minus x, and in the denominator it is 6. Here you get minus 9 by 20. This is also correct. After that, you do the cross multiplication. So once you do the cross multiplication, then we get 20 into minus x is equal to minus 9 into 6. Simplify this, we get x equals 27 by 10. That is 2.7. Perfectly fine. So this first question is correct. Now coming to the second part. N by 2 minus 3n by 4 plus 5n by 6 is equal to 21. Very simple. You have all the terms containing n on the left hand side. You can take LCM and simplify. And on the right side we have 21. So when we simplify, we get this as minus 3n plus 10n by 12 is equal to 21. So we get 7n by 12. Okay. Is equal to 21. So x equals 21 into 12 by 7. So we can cancel 21 by 7. We are left with 12 into 3, that is 36. Perfectly fine. So this part is also right. Coming to the next one, x plus 7 minus 8x by 3 equals 17 by 6 minus 5x by 2. Okay. So here also you have brought terms containing x to the left hand side, so you get x minus 8x by 3, and you see here it is minus 5x by 2 on the right hand side. It can be brought to the left hand side, so it becomes plus 5x by 2. Perfectly fine. So this is equal to 17 by 6 minus 7. This step is correct. Now you can take 6 as LCM. So 6x minus 16x plus 15x, perfectly fine, is equal to 17 minus 42 by 6. This is also correct. Now simplify, we get 5x by 6 equals minus 25 by 6. Okay, x equals minus 25 by 6 into 6 by 5. 6 and 6 gets cancelled. 5 5s are 25, so we are left with minus 5. Perfectly fine. So x is equal to minus 5 is the answer. Okay, let us discuss this word problem. The denominator of a rational number is greater than the numerator by 8. Okay, if the numerator is increased by 17 and denominator is decreased by 1, the number obtained is 3 by 2. We have discussed such questions in our class also. So we have to find the rational number here. Okay, we assume that numerator of the rational number be x, and the denominator is 8 more than this. So this will be x plus 8. And it is given that if numerator is increased by 17, so we get x plus 17, and denominator is decreased by 1, that means x plus 8 minus 1. Perfectly fine. So this equation is framed correctly. Then we do the cross multiplication. So 2 into x plus 17 equals 3 into x plus 7. 8 minus 1 is 7. Perfectly fine. Simplify, we get x equals 13. This is also correct. Now we see that the denominator is 8 more than the numerator. So 13 plus 8, 21. So 13 by 21 is correct answer. Coming to the last one, this is ages of Hari and Harry are in the ratio 5:7. Okay, so 4 years from now, the ratio of their ages will be 3:4. Find their present ages. Very interesting question. So here, let x be the common factor. Okay, so you get Hari's age 5x and Harry's age 7x. So 4 years from now, okay, we will be adding 4 to both the ages of Hari and Harry. So 5x plus 4 upon 7x plus 4, it is given that it is in the ratio 3:4, so 3/4. We simplify this by cross multiplication. We get x equals 4. Okay, this is perfectly fine. So age of Hari is 5 × 4, 20 years, and age of Harry is 28 years. Yes, all these questions are correct. So I am now closing the discussion of this. Fine. Thank you so much.